Okay, let's kick things off. Thank you so much, everybody, for joining us today. We're really excited to present to you our next generation smart cloud platform. My name is Alex Gregory, and I'm here with Ravi, our senior cloud architect. So a little bit about myself. I've joined The Missing Link in July, and I've come from Dell Technologies, where I was there for 11 years. And Ravi, I'll just get you to say hi quickly.
Hi, I'm Ravinder Krishnan. So I'm a senior cloud architect. So previously I've been working for a different cloud provider and been working with The Missing Link for the last probably close to a year now.
Thanks, Ravi. Ravi has built our smart cloud platform. So you'll see from him in a little while a demonstration of everything that is built and what you guys can be using in the future. Our agenda today, we'll go over what our smart cloud platform is, the platform architecture, the services that you can consume on it, some of the key features, the advantages that our platform provides you. And as I mentioned, Ravi will then go into a live demonstration. So what is our next generation smart cloud platform? It is The Missing Link's owned and operated private cloud platform. It offers infrastructure as a service and also a platform as a service. And those are the additional features that we offer on top of just running your regular VMs day in, day out. Our architecture looks like this. It is built on VMware Cloud Director. That's the interface that you would see and utilize for your day-to-day interactions with it. Underneath that, it's built on the Dell Technologies VxRail platform. Our switching is provided by Cisco, and all of our infrastructure sits in Equinix, whether it's in our Sydney data center or in the Melbourne data center. And this is the high-level diagram of how it looks and what we're utilizing here. So hyper-converged infrastructure, so all of our storage sits up into those servers. And some of the servers you can see here, our Smart Protect platform, how it replicates. It's utilizing SmartPath, which is The Missing Link's internet service provider connectivity. And as I mentioned, we sit in the Sydney data center, and we also have the Melbourne data center as well. So like any cloud platform, we offer the ability to run your VMs, whether they run on Windows or Linux, that's fine. And you can have it sitting on our shared host, which is the default, or you can procure through us your dedicated hardware, and all your VMs will sit on your own hardware, and you'll still consume it just like you would through the shared host. All of our storage is SSD, and like on our cloud platform, unlike the hyperscalers, you don't have any other additional costs associated with that storage. So whether you're making however many calls you make to that SSD storage, we don't track any of that. It's just an allocation of per gigabyte billing. For the networking, our best benefit here is the internet connection is not metered in terms of how much data you transfer through it. You'll get a certain bandwidth per month that you can choose, and how you use that is up to you. That's your bandwidth to use as you please. Built into our systems, you can use the VMware NSXT platform for your networking, which gives you a gateway firewall and load balancers. You can also have the additional upsell of the FortiGate firewalls, as well as a Citrix NetScaler, or you can have your own private WAN. Licensing, you can build into our monthly billing. That can be from Microsoft, Citrix, Sophos, or you can have our SSL certificate as well. So the additional services that we offer on top of that platform is our Smart Protect platform and DR as a service. So with Smart Protect, that's going to give you the ability to back up all of the VMs that sit on that. That gives you some offsite replication. And our Smart Protect platform is completely built on Veeam, which then utilizes the SSD storage for that. So that's a pretty big benefit. There's not a lot of storage systems that are completely built on SSD storage, which is great, makes it incredibly fast, really quick to recover your VMs in a disaster scenario. You do have the ability to long-term archive that into Glacier if it's something that you don't need to access. It might be your yearlies or, you know, potentially something even older that you don't think you'll need to access. DR as a service is an incredibly great use case for our cloud platform. So you can DR the VMs that sit in our cloud platform, or you can DR the VMs that sit in your own on-premise VMware deployment. So You can replicate your VMs into the Smart Cloud platform and just pay for the storage that you're using. And if there's ever a scenario that you want to use that, then you just spin up that VM and you pay for the VM running at that point in time. We offer you a 5-minute incremental billing. So if you want to turn that VM on, to shut that VM down, you don't need to pay for that VM for the whole month. It's just that 5-minute billing increments that you'll be looking to pay for. We have built-in monitoring tools with basic monitoring from Enable or some more advanced monitoring from Logic Monitor. And coming in H1 2023, we'll have the VMware Tanzu platform, which will give you the ability to run Kubernetes containers on our smart cloud. Some of the key features is that we are ISO 27001. That is an information management accreditation that we're audited annually on. The missing link as a whole holds that accreditation, and our smart platform, and it extends into that as well. As I mentioned, we're built by VMware from the ground up. So everything you interact with on our platform is VMware Cloud Director, and it gives you that really similar look to vCenter if you're familiar with how to use that. We are completely based in Australia. As I said, our locations are in Sydney and Melbourne, and we have options to have dedicated hosts if you would like to do that. Our VMs, you don't have to use a t-shirt size VM. So you might click a drop down and choose two vCPU with 16 gig of RAM. But if you actually wanted to have two vCPUs with 48 or 96 gig of RAM, that's an option for you on our platform. It doesn't have to be a predetermined VM size. We are self-service, which is great on our next-gen platform, which means that you don't need to log a trouble ticket to change your backups. You don't need to log a trouble ticket to create a DR. This is all self-service. If you want to spin up a new VM, if you want to shut one down, if you want to migrate, if you want to do anything on our platform, you can do it yourself. Disaster recovery is built in. There's no additional sites that you need to go to turn this on. It's all within our platform. And our support is all based in Australia, and we currently have a 98% customer satisfaction rate, which always hovers around there. It's been 99%. We had a month where we were at 100%, which is extremely good considering that customers only call in with a problem. No one's calling us to tell us that we're doing great, or at least they're not calling the support line. So a really great job that our team's doing there. And I'll just touch on, if you wanted to get the ability to call into a call center with, for example, Microsoft Azure, that's an additional $1,000 a month that you need to add on. So if you're running one VM in Azure and you want to call their support line, it'll cost you $20 or say per hour for the VM, plus $1,000 for the month just to have the ability to call them. For us, that's all included, and you won't need to have any additional costs. So a really good way to just dip your toes in if you wanted to, you know, protect a VM. If you wanted to run a couple of VMs in our platform, you're still going to get the support from us, and you're not going to have to pay an arm and a leg for that additional service. So why use our Smart Cloud platform? As I mentioned, that we are completely VMware certified, and that gives you the ability to bring your VMs onto our platform and migrate them in a really easy manner. We offer simple and predictable billing. As I mentioned before, we don't have any egress costs on our platform. So if you move a lot of data around, you're not going to get a bill shock at the end of the month. If you use a lot of your storage or a lot of your SSD storage, we won't even monitor that. We're not going to know how much you're moving your data around within your storage. We know how much you're using per month, and you'll know that as well, and you'll get a bill based on that. Our systems, we offer a managed service. So if you wanted some assistance with your VMs, if you wanted us to monitor them, if you want us to run the applications that run on that for you, we do have that as a service as well. And your data will sit all in Australia. We know that with a lot of hyperscalers, you do have the option of having your data sit in Australia. However, these are American companies. Your data, some of that information about your company, about your billing, who you are, that type of thing is going to sit in other countries. So for us, everything, all our offices related to the Smart Cloud is in Australia. We do have a UK office. It's a satellite office that some of our security teams sit in. So with us, all of your data will sit on premise and in Australia. but it's also going to be all that metadata around who you are and your company and how you interact with us. That's all within Australia. As I mentioned, it does sit on the Dell Technologies VxRail platform. This is enterprise, it's all brand new, and it's all completely under warranty, 24-hour support with a 4-hour on-site, which means, you know, this isn't sort of ad hoc, hardware that we've got here. It is very much the latest in enterprise-grade systems. And as I mentioned before, our team is onshore. Everyone you call at the Missing Link here, when you have if you have any issues or you'd like to get some support, they are based in Australia. So as I mentioned, we have built-in DR as a service, a really great use case and a really easy way to dip your toes into the Smart Cloud platform is to replicate your VMs into our platform, whether it be if they're being protected or if you just want to run a couple of workloads, you could start with that, or you could, you know, migrate all of your applications and start using it on a larger scale. So simple migration, if you have an existing vCenter server, you will be able to federate that with our Smart Cloud platform. And then from there, it's just to move your VMs over one by one. That is built into the platform. So migration as a service is there. You can do it yourself. You won't have to outsource that or pay anybody to do that for you, as it's so simple. And as I mentioned, our backup platform, Smart Protect, is built into our Smart Cloud. That is run by Veeam and sitting on all our SSD storage. So as promised, let's jump over to Ravi now, who's going to give us a look through. Now, please feel free to ask any questions. I'm going to be monitoring the Q&A, and I'll bring them up, and Ravi can and I myself can answer them as we go through that. So thanks very much, and I'll hand it over to Ravi.
Thanks, everyone. Thanks, everyone, for joining this call. So I'm just going to quickly share my screen and show a short demo about our Smart Cloud. Alex, you can see my screen?
Yes, that's come up.
All right, thank you. All right, so this is I'm just going to show how the tenant is going to, as a customer, or is going to log into the Smart Cloud tenancy, and then what are the capabilities they can access, what some of the things which Alex was explaining. So some of the things I can show you in the live demo. So I'm logging into a tenant called TMLI demo as a user. Tenant user, so that's me. Just to highlight, so I've logged in as a user with a username and the passwords, but this also can be integrated with MFA as well. So multi-factor authentication can be integrated. If a customer has got an Azure tenancy, so we can integrate with that, or if they have an ADFS in an on-prem, we can integrate the MFA with that. So this is basically the landing page. Once you log in as a customer, so I've logged in as R. Krishnan and an organization administrator up here. This is the landing page where you come into a data center. So in this case, I've got just one single data center called TMLI demo, SID1 OVDC. So you can in an example, so you can have a production data center here. You can also have a demo or even a development data center or even a testing or something like that. So you can have a non-production one as well. So you can view both the production and the non-production data center within the single organization, and you can go into the data center itself. So now I'm logging into the organization virtual data center. In this landing page, as you can see, you would be able to see the virtual apps, which is basically the container for all the virtual machines combined together, where you can power on and power off. You can perform certain tasks. So that's the VApp. And you can see here the virtual machines. So these are the virtual machines that's been deployed in this tenancy. This is where you can actually see the networks. Actually, you can go and create the virtual networks. This networks runs on NSXT, as Alex mentioned. So nothing to touch on any physical layer. So everything is virtualized, which is running on Genevieve networks. This one is the edges where this is the edge gateway. This is the gateway to your organization virtual data center where you can configure different firewall rules for north-south traffic. And you can also configure firewall rules for the distributed firewall for the east-west for the VMs between the between any two VMs. So I'll just quickly go into the application. This is another view where you can actually see the VApps as well as the virtual machines here. And this one is basically networking. This is where you can come in and create some networks. You can also have a view of the edge gateways, what you can see. This one is a data center group. So as I said, so you can create two virtual data center and you can put them into a data center group and then you can manage them together. And you can also put some security tags as well. So once I'll just go through all the tabs, what is available, and then I'll just demonstrate to you quickly what you can do and things like that. So here you can see the library. So this is where what we have done is basically published some, we have created a catalog and published some few templates here. This will be constantly updated and new templates will be published and all the customers can utilize the templates and deploy the virtual machines and you know, any ISO files, you can upload it and all the things can be done from here. The customer also has got an option to go and create their own catalog. For example, if you wanted to upload any sort of ISO image, customized template, any sort of things, they can create a catalog by themselves and they can upload the templates as well as any ISO images here. If you wanted to use your own templates, so you still have those options. And here is the administration tab. So here, this is where you can actually create the SAML or LDAP. If you have Active Directory, you can actually also link up to an Active Directory, or you can also do SAML here. This is where you will be creating some users and groups. So basically, when a customer logs in, one user will have a full tenant organization administrator, and then that that user can create multiple user accounts for other people's and giving them some granular permissions and what they can actually perform. Right, and this section here, the certificate library, for example, if you're hosting a website and if you wanted to put a SSL certificate in here and attach to that website, this is where you can come in here, put the upload your certificate, SSL certificate into the library as well. Right, and monitor, this is basically actually gives you this is just a task and event section where it can actually show you who has performed what basic functions. And what are the events that has been done so far. And here, this section here, you can, I think Alex touched a little bit on, you know, DRSS service, which is basically the availability. That's the DRSS. We will dive more into it and I'll just show you a demo so quickly what are the functions we can perform. Operations manager is basically the billing section where you should be, you would be able to see the bills and you can also see the reports that's been generated. The bills will be automatically generated on a specific date whenever the customer signed up. You will be able to see the bills as well. Data protection with VM, this is where the backup as a service, which is going to happen. So as you can see, everything is tightly integrated into the vCloud Director portal itself, which is, gives you the ability to do a self-service for backup, billing, and the DRSS service, and also migration at the same time as well. All right. So now what I'm going to show you is quickly, I'll go into the networking. And I'll quickly show you where we can create a network. So this is where you go in here. You can create a routed network. As you can see, it's connected to an edge gateway, which is the TMLI demo edge gateway. This is the north-south. This is the edge of the data center itself. So here I can go in here. I can say test 04 and give a gateway, for example, 192.168.100.1/24. And I can give it that range here, 192.168.100.2, 192.100.10. So I'm just giving a range, so probably from 2 to 10. This is where you can add range. And you can even give a primary DNS, secondary DNS if you wanted to. You can also create a template as well if you like it. And next and finish. So this is basically actually creating a virtual network within your organization virtual data center. Once the network is created, so you can go into the applications here. If you want, you can create a VApp, or if you wanted to deploy a virtual machine, you can go in here, new VM. So you can say test 10 or something, and you can select the template which we already published. So I can select the 2019 here. And the storage policy is already predefined. You can also select different storage policies. For example, if you want more protection, the failure to tolerate one or failure to tolerate two. So you have more protection as well. You have the options as well. Here, Alex was talking about the t-shirt size. This is where you can actually select the sizes. You know, whatever the sizes you want, you also have an option to select the custom VM size. So you can put select the custom VM size, and that gives you the capability to change the CPU and memory, whatever the size you would like. All right, so I'm just deploying a new VM. So now I can connect to test 04, which I deployed. Then I can say static IP pool because I've just created an IP pool in there. And then click OK. So there's nothing else. So then, OK. So this one, you can see the test 10. So this VM is getting spun up. So while this VM is running and that's happening, so I just wanted to quickly show you some functions within the networking. So let me dive into the edge gateway. So edge gateway, which as I said, this is the edge of the data center. This is where you actually perform different functions. For example, as you can see, firewall here. So here I've just put some firewall rules. So this is where the north-south traffic. So you can actually put, if you wanted to go out to the internet or you wanted to block something from internet, this is where you come in and put the firewall rules. As you can see, I've put an internet and said that demo VM03 and VM02. So these can actually go out to the internet. And this is where you come in and put the north-south firewall rule. And within the same edge gateway, you also have the function to put NAT rules as well. So you can actually create a source NAT, or you also have an option to create a DNAT and a source NAT as well. And you can also do no DNAT and no SNAT as well in here. So the function here, you got the firewall rules, you got the NAT functions which you can put in. You also have your edge gateway also performs the IPsec VPN as well. So you can have an IPsec VPN tunnel between this edge gateway, or even on Azure, you can connect them both together. And you also have an option to do an L2 VPN as well. This edge gateway also functions as a load balancer. I'll just show you, I've just created a website as well. So I can just show you how the load balancing function is working. So here you have the virtual service. This is where you can actually create a VIP, which is a virtual IP, and then you can associate it with a pool at the back end. So I've created a demo site here, which is connected to a service pool called demo pool. So that's where this pool is there. So, and it's got two VMs that's running, and it's hosting a website, just a hello website kind of thing. And I've just connected to two VMs in here. So this is all self-service. You can come in and create a load balancer, and you can host a website, and then you can use the SSL certificate which you have uploaded in the library, and then come and put it here. Okay, so this is the function, a quick view of the edge gateway and some of the functions which you can see. What I'll do is I quickly go into some of the integration, which is what I quickly want to show you. As I said before, this is VCDA, which is availability, DR as a service, or migration as a service. So I'm going to quickly go into that. So once I'm in here, so incoming replication. So if I wanted to create or migration, if I want to do a DR, which DR is a service, or if I wanted to migrate from an on-premises, if you already have, or on a different cloud, right? So you can come in here, you can click on new migration. I can say DR, so I'm just picking up this VM here. This is actually running on an on-premises, a completely a different vCenter, which is on-premises. I'm just going to quickly pick this VM, DR test. And I'm sending it to the TMLI demo. That's the data center which I want to send it. I can also select here what storage policy I want. And I can also select delay start synchronization. If you want to do a migration, you know, off peak or whatever the time outside of the business hours, you can certainly do that as well. You can also exclude the disk if you don't want to do it, some disk. And this is where you come in here, incoming migration, and you can click on it and then finish. So this will actually migrate the VM from the VM vCenter into the Smart Cloud Organization Virtual Data Center. So while that's happening, I'm just going to quickly go into the data protection with Veeam. As we said, it's already self-service and integrated into the portal itself. So here you can go here. It's now it's connecting back into the VM. Sorry, Veeam. So you can come in here. You can create a job here. For example, if I want to do a test again. Click next. I want to select the virtual machine. So I'm going into the TMLI demo, which is our organization. And as you can see, the test 10 VM, which I previously created. You can select the VM. And you can even do application aware processing and also guest file system indexing if you wanted to index it. So you can click on this, next, next, and finish. Okay, so that has created a backup job. So you can click on it and you can run the job. So this will send the backups to our target backup, which is to the Smart Protect. Basically, we're running the Smart Protect. So while that's happening, I'll just see what is happening with the vCloud Director here. Sorry, the migration which we kicked off. So which is this one? As you can see, it's at 81%. Synchronizing at this point of time, so that will take a while to finish it. While that's happening, I just want to quickly show you the billing side of it. So as I said, that's called as Operations Manager. Again, it's self-integrated into the portal itself, so you can here you can see the bills. So this bill, these bills can be scheduled, or we can even run an on-demand bill at the back end. Sorry, at the back end, but generally these bills are scheduled on a monthly date. So you can come in here. You can come and have a look at the bills. This will give a big breakdown of the you know, the VApp, how many VMs you got, how much it's charged for the storage, and few bits and pieces here. So this is where you can come and have a look at the billing. You can also look at the reports as well. So at the same time, this can be scheduled at the back end. So you can actually come and have a look at the bill, and also you can look at the reports whether everything is aligned together. So you can actually cross check whether the bill is actually tallying up with the reports, what is coming up. So these are the three integration. One is the RAS, which is the DR as a service, and also migration as a service. Okay, so I'll just quickly go here. That's happening. So it's already 85% synchronizing. So as I said before, this is the migration and that one is the protection. So if you're doing a DRS service, you would be doing that, and that's for the migration. Okay. So we talked about the operations manager, which is the billing. We talked about the Veeam backup. I'll just quickly go back to the job, what is happening. So that's running at this point of time. So it's actually doing the backup. While that's doing the backup, I just want to quickly go in here, the Edge Gateway, sorry, the Data Center Group. Okay, so I want to talk about the distributed firewall, which I touched earlier. So the one which we saw on the Edge Gateway is the north-south firewall, which is out to the internet and in and out. The distributed firewall is the east-west firewall traffic between. So if you wanted to restrict any VMs which is running on the same network, and you wanted those two VMs to talk between each other, so you can actually come in and put the firewall rules here. So you can basically come in here, you can actually add a new firewall rule here and say, what is my source and what is my destination, whether you want to allow, what protocol, and you can also even log it as well. So this is where you come and put in the distributed firewall, which is basically the east-west firewall, which is between the VMs. What else? So we talked about the networks. We talked about how we can deploy the virtual machines. We also looked at the data center. We also looked at the library where we can actually come in and upload the catalogs, create catalogs and upload templates, customize templates, or you can use our templates as well. And I think we talked about the where we can create the users, and we also touched on the library where you can actually upload the SSL certificates and things like that. Alex, back to you. Yep.
Thank you so much, Ravi. That was excellent. I love seeing that every time I get to do these. I really enjoy the demo part. It's not often you get a live hands-on, not pre-recorded. So really great to see that it went well and everything's so simple in that interface. So thank you very much, everybody, for your time. I will let you know that we do have, internally to our sales team, we have some calculators. So if you'd like to know, what would it cost to run these VMs, we can do an analysis of your existing VM infrastructure, and we can put that into our calculator and just give you an idea of what it might cost you month to month on this platform. We could also show you what it might cost you to protect those on-premise VMs into our Smart Cloud platform. So please do reach out to your account manager for any more information. If you're not sure who to contact, you can reach me. My contact details are there on the screen. Feel free to screenshot that now. But thank you so much. Have a really great rest of your day and afternoon. And we hope to hear from you soon.